ask you, my Father, as we are here, my Lord Jesus, to say goodbye to Miss Florence. And in our Christian faith, we believe that her soul is already resting at your bosom. And we ask, may your Holy Spirit can prepare our hearts to receive this message, because it's a moment when we have to meditate, we have to think about the future of our own soul. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we ask you. John, the chapter 14, this message for you, family members, friends, that you are feeling that you are losing a family member, a loved person. But the same the Lord Jesus said when he was about to sacrifice his life on the cross, he prepared you, he spoke to the disciples, and he said, I will leave this world. And the disciples, they start to show that they were sad because they were losing their master. But the Lord Jesus said these words here. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. That's where I am, that you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. In other words, the Lord Jesus was saying, he prepared a way for all of us there in heaven. We believe that our soul is already there. And this moment to show us that we have to think about the future of us. Serving God, she served God more than 10 years as a volunteer, dedicating her life to help others, dedicating her life to save souls as she saved her own soul, because the same faith that she showed when she was alive, keeping her faith in Jesus, be faithful to God, she kept her faith until the end. Now, another Bible verse says, I fought the good fight, I finished the race, and I kept my faith. In other words, Miss Florence, she kept her faith because she finished the race, fighting the good fight. Then it's a moment for all of us now think about the future of our soul, because in the same way that just arrived her time to go to God, to heaven, our time will arrive one day, and we have to prepare the way of our souls. Now let's say a short prayer. Before we say a prayer, I will invite you to bow down your head and think about the future of our soul. And if you need to ask God for some reason forgiveness for your own mistakes and wrongs, you are free to say to God and say, Lord, forgive my sins, my mistakes, my wrongs. Because as Miss Florence, she now is showing us through her example, because she fought the good fight. She was racing, my Lord, running this race of life in faith. She finished the race. She kept her faith. And all of us, we want to do the same. We want to serve you with our lives until the end. Receive our lives into your hands right now, because we give you thanks for the example of Miss Florence, the example that she showed us through her Christian life, the way that all of us we have to do. We give you thanks, and we ask, give us the strength that all of us we have to need to keep fighting the good fight, to finish our own race and keep our faith. If you believe, say, I believe in Jesus' name. Amen. I remember that on Christmas Day, I just received a cake. She was a very good professional cooker. And the assistant priest, he brought to me the cake and he said, this is a gift from Miss Florence. And I was not believing that she made the cake. It was very beautiful. And next time she came, the same week after Christmas, and I had the privilege to say to her, thank you very much. I didn't believe that was you that made that cake. And it was the last time that I spoke to her. But I saw that she was strong in her faith, physically fighting for all the drawbacks, the situation that she was feeling regarding her health, but spiritually speaking, strong. And she even said, I didn't come to Christmas because I thought that I was going to Abraham's Boston Marathon. That all the time she was thinking about and preparing herself to this day. And it's a day that all of us will have to take for ourselves to meditate. I would like to sing a song that she loved to sing. The number... to leave the world behind, to leave the fleshly words behind, and we decide to follow Jesus' faith. Can you help? I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. I got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Oh, my world, I stay no longer with you, goodbye pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you, I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Hold my world, I stay no longer with you,
Goodbye, pleasures of sin. I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Born again. Thank God I'm born again. 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 Born of the water, the spirit, the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Born of the water, the spirit, and the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Born of the water, the spirit, and the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Born of the water, the spirit, and the blood. Thank God I'm born again. Let's sing another one. This was a time when we were rejoicing. She was, all the time she was even following the songs even. Let's sing this one here. That shows the grace of our Lord Jesus towards all of us, because even though we are, all of us, we are sinners and human beings, He always gives us the opportunity to start again. Every day is a new opportunity to start again. The number three, that says amazing grace. Thank you.
number. I can only imagine what to be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine where my eyes can see, where your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? We white dance for you, Jesus. I sing hallelujah. We'll be able to speak at all. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when the day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine. When I all will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? When I'm all being still, will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall, will I sing hallelujah? Will be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Like to sing a song? You like to sing a song? The one that is here?
Sing what?
The number?
Seven.
Seven.
Number seven. Okay. He walks out in peace, oh God, he runs. He died. Most blessed, most glorious, the ancient of days,
almighty, victorious, thy great name we praise. Unresting, unhasting, and silent as night, now wanting, always in.
Thou rulest in might, thy justice like mountains high soaring above. Thy clouds teach us fountains of goodness and love. To all thy forgiveness, in all greatness form, in all life thy lives, the true life of all.
Final prayer. We finish the service. like to ask you to place your right hand upon your heart. Lord Jesus, we give you thanks because even though we are saying goodbye for Miss Florence, our hearts, my Lord, we have the assurance that she is happy with you. She's saved. And we surrender our hearts into your hands as well. And we give you thanks for this moment here, because even though we are saying goodbye, we are praising you, we are praising your holy name, because she fought the good fight, finished the race, and kept the faith. We give you thanks in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we surrender our lives into your hands. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Of everybody and their family back home, I render thank you to all of you. Pastor, thank you for coming. All of you that have taken the time to come this very cold weather. Florence was a fantastic mother, a Christian mother, somebody who loved, whose charity you know about, woman of integrity, a Christian who applied her Christian values in everything she did. She lived by example. She helped many. Many sought Florence's counsel. Florence had a motto, forgiveness. Forgive them. Summon them to God and pray for them. That was Florence. That's her legacy. She touched many lives. She touched many lives. But she's in a better place. The Lord said, in my Father's house there are many mansions. And I pray that Florence will be given a penthouse with a very big kitchen where she can continue to bake cakes for the angels. Yeah? She will be missed by many. She was a good woman. She lived by example. So as she lived for forgiveness, let us all learn from Florence. Forgive, summon them to God, and pray for them as well. Thank you very much for coming. And God bless you all. Florence has appreciated everything. She's here with us, in spirit. And she's in a better place. And we thank God for that. God bless you all.
Thank you.
And say the goodbye. Afterwards, we have to stand by the building for they come to come and put it, and then we come back again when they finish.
music.
Is it you or me?
Oh my God, it's me.
Is it you? Yeah, can you just turn this one off?
Okay, yeah.
Thank you. Hello? Yeah, please, I wanted to take a little tribute. How you guys related to Auntie Florence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you want to start.
Mm-hmm. Okay, my name is Hazel. Hello. We obviously knew Auntie Florence from our church community more than 30 years now. And what I can say is that she had a very good sense of humor, very kind, loving lady. But she was full of faith, always encouraged you. And her words and her lessons was always about follow Jesus, keep going. And she lived and practiced it, per se. You know, she always encouraged you to, you know, enjoy your life, but most importantly, put God first. And she was a very faithful, committed member. When it came to cooking, she also gave wonderful advice on cooking.
Was it just about cakes or?
Yes. So we had the privilege of her cakes and her jollof and lovely dishes, really. Yeah. And it's been amazing, and the memories is just going to remain with us in our hearts. So, and we loved her dearly.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I remember Mama Florence, because I call her Mama Florence. Mm-hmm. And I remember, this is way years before I got married, and she said, Diane, come. And she will pull over a bit, and she will pat the chair,
sit
here for a bit. And I knew it was her advice that she was being prepared to give me. And I will always remember, she always saying, everything that you do, before you put your uniform on, you go before the altar and you pray. Mm-hmm. And let God guide you. And I'll never forget that.
Yes.
And I remember even one day she was speaking to me. She would speak to me about give words of wisdom.
Yes.
Her words of wisdom was always genuine, was always helpful. And she brought this huge bag. One day she came to church with this huge bag. I was like, what's all in that bag? And she, Diane, come.
Pictures.
Again, sit down.
Stories.
Stories. She showed pictures, albums of her past, her life, her cooking, her baking, her designs, who she used to work for.
Yeah.
You know, people high above, how she used to prepare and stuff. It was so amazing to see that life that I never knew beforehand.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And it was just so amazing. And it's something that will always be with me forever.
Amazing.
So, yes.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Okay. Thank you.
You're very welcome. I appreciate it. Gentlemen, do you have anything? If I'll move. I'm not there. I know your group have said enough, but if you have any little to add, that would be good.
Okay, what I'll add is, my name's Chris, and let's say Aunt Florence, she was a special woman. And when I say special, I'm not just saying, as we always say when people buzz, say, oh, they're special. Mm-hmm. She showed in her humbleness, in her kindness. Mm-hmm. She'll give, just give. Everybody she meets, she'll give. She's a very forgiving person as well. And she reflects the light of Christ wherever she went. And she always had words of wisdom. But my main thing, what I'll say over this is, and I'll say to everybody, Mrs. Florence was faithful. And when I say faithful, from what I see, faithful to God. That's why even at this moment, you know, it's kind of complex, but there's a sort of joy because we know she made it through. And it's something as an example that we have to ask ourselves. Are we that faithful to come through?
Mm-hmm.
Are we that faithful? And question ourselves about our relationship with God. Not our church, but our relationship with God and be that faithful. So Mrs. Florence, you know, made it through. That's all I know. She made it through. Glory to God.
I've been. Pastor says his soul. Hello, second group. I wanted to find out whether you had any relationship with Auntie Florence and what little stuff you want to say about her. Just for people to be able to reflect on her and know the sort of person that she was.
Yeah, Florence is a very, very, very good
very humble, helpful person, always willing to listen to other people's problems, always willing to assist people. I mean, most times you go and tell her issues that are going to, she always listens. And she even makes you laugh because she laughs about his life as if, relax, this is not a big thing. And sometimes I visit her and when I'm driving, driving away from her, this one there, she makes everything look so simple. So she doesn't make you to feel that you're even under pressure. So for that reason, I always say, well, God has given her something. We all have to give them, we all have. But I keep saying, well, thank God for her. And at the moment, Father, she's left us, I would say she's in a better place. much better place. And we just for one day, we'll go and meet her there too. So, this is her.
Amen. So you came from the same church or you knew her from the community?
No, me, she's a cousin of mine.
Uncle? Oh, yeah. Nice. Oh, nice.
I know her that much.
Nice.
Okay, I even saw her less than a month past. It was between Christmas Day. I went there for lunch, Christmas lunch.
Oh.
And went, no.
What did she cook?
Well, she does a lot of cooking. I mean, she's not for that. Cakes and everything. You visit her when you leave, you make sure she gives a lot of stuff. You know, a lot of stuffs, cakes and all this sort of things. So it was very painful when I heard that. Less than a month, you know, she passed. But you know, still God disposed it, so just have to accept that.
May her soul rest in peace.
Yeah, exactly.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, guys. Mommy, do you want to say something? No. Yeah, you said it. Thank you very much. Hello, third group. How would you remember Auntie Florence, please?
It's right now. I can't find the words. I'm very sorry.
It's just all too much.
Yeah, too much.
It happens and I understand. I appreciate. Thank you. Hello, 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 hello. Yes, please. I wanted to see whether I could take a little tribute or, you know, for Auntie Florence. How you guys knew him, knew her, and what sort of person she was, you know. I never met her.
Oh, okay. I only came to support. I've never met her.
Okay.
And, yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Thank you.
Well, I've known her for so many years. And for some time we're not seeing each other. But luckily she looked for me just about a month or two before she passed on.
Okay.
Some years ago when I was at home, she was always with me. When my kids were little, she was always coming to me, my house. We were baking, she was baking for us. Christmas time, when after work she would pass there, she would bring us things, fish, this, you know, she was very nice. Taught me how to do nice donuts and whatnot. In fact, she was spending most of the time with me. But as the children grew up and I started working, we were not, we only speak for the food.
Yes.
Later on, we lost touch. But just before, about, say, December or November, something, when did I go to Ghana? I went to Ghana. When I came back, I said, oh, I have to call her. Then all of a sudden, I had a phone call that she's passed. And we even planned to see each other after the pandemic, hopefully.
You know, that's what they say, that humans are spirits. Sometimes when you feel some things within you, you know, it's for a purpose.
Yes. When I came from Ghana, I said, well, I have to call her. Then all of a sudden, but God knows best. So she's resting in peace. Yes, she is resting in peace.
I mean, thank you very much for that lovely tribute. Thank you. Young man, what do you want to say about Auntie Florence? What little tribute do you want to give about her?
Okay, Auntie Florence was like a second mother for me. Our relationship goes back to my childhood.
Okay.
To when I was a baby. She was a very caring, loving, and empathetic person, like everybody knows. My first birthday, or my second birthday, she brought a fantastic cake. She's well known for her culinary skills.
Yeah.
And she really made my day. And from that day, our bond has been very strong.
Second birthday.
Yes.
How do... Second birthday.
I have the pictures there and I can remember
okay.
it.
Okay.
I can remember it.
Wow.
So, then, you know, the sad news arrived that Auntie Florence had passed and it really hit us. We pray for her soul. We're thankful for her life. And may her soul rest in peace.
Thank you very much for coming to show your love. Thank you. God bless you.
You too.
Hello, ladies. Good afternoon. Yeah, I wanted to see whether you have any little tribute for to celebrate the life of Auntie Florence. I never knew her, so I'm getting to.
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, is the hearse ready now? Okay, I'll come back to you. The head. Put that one at the front here. This one here. Where's the head? Oh, that's the head. Yeah. So, okay. So this one can be at the side. Yeah. And then this is after. Yeah. 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 So side. Yeah. The other way around, yeah.
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 Need to face this
yeah. No, yeah, at least face, yeah. Yeah. Step over it. That can be at the top, yeah. Yeah. There. At the top, yeah. Yeah. That's it, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. In the middle. Okay. In smaller groups, you can be at the head, and then I'll take just some few pictures here. In smaller groups, threes and fours, please. Threes and fours. Thank you very much. Yeah, say bye-bye and thank the family back at home, and then I can end the live stream here.
Well, bye-bye everybody. We thank the family back home. We know you're assembling to listen to us and watch this. And we hope that the family back home appreciate the send-off we've given Auntie Florence. I hope they do appreciate, and I know they do appreciate what we've done for her. And we thank everybody, and as I said, Christian woman, we salute her. We salute her. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.